Now I want to conclude this discussion on refactoring by telling you when you should not refactor. One first clear case is when your code is broken. I want to make it very clear, refactoring is not a way to fix your code in terms of its functionality. It's a way to improve the design of your code. So if your code does not compile or does not run in a stable way, it's probably better to throw it away and rewrite it rather than trying to refactor it. By definition, refactoring should maintain the functionality of the system, should be behavior preserving. So if the code was broken before, it's probably going to be broken afterwards as well. You may also want to avoid refactoring when a deadline is close. Well, first of all, because refactoring might take a long time and therefore might introduce risks of being late for the deadline. And also because of what we said before about introducing problems, you don't want to introduce problems that might take you time to fix right before a deadline. So if the deadline is too close, you might want to avoid refactoring the code at that point. And finally, do not refactor if there is no reason to. As we said before, you should refactor on demand. You see a problem with the design of your code, with the structure of your code, it's okay to refactor. If the code is fine, there is no reason to refactor. I know that refactoring is fun, but you don't want to do it all the time. The next thing I want to discuss after discussing when not to refactor is when to refactor. When are the indications that will tell us that it's time to refactor the code? And that leads us to the discussion of a very interesting concept.